sharing God's word, worship, and honor to meet you at your need and where you stand. You are listening to Praise On.
And I praise is shifting the atmosphere.
As we shared there in Colorado, it was truly a celebration. I felt that way. The homegoing for our beloved sister, Flo. I want you to know you live your funeral. Yeah. There ain't nothing we can do after you go on to help you. We trying to help the family and visitors out there that are still lost. Flo had a life well lived. Born to a loving family. The six of 12 children in a little town called Carson Lake, Arkansas. Some of y'all might even know what that's at. Carson Lake. I told him, Carol had me looking for a big lake. I got there, wasn't nothing but a ditch, it wasn't no water in it. Graduated from high school and attended Arkansas State University. Served the country in the United States Air Force for over 20 years. She traveled the world. Look at God. From Carson Lake to traveling the world. The wife of one husband for over 40 years. Amen. I think that deserves an amen. Amen. They didn't amen at church. They were just quiet. Learning over words kind of scared them a little bit. But we had to go there to get it where we go. And him, her husband Smitty, was the husband of one wife. Supported her to the last day on this side. That's a life well lived. To this union, they had two children. She loves her sisters and her brothers. She once told me, said, Mike, I don't believe in in-laws. We brothers. Now, Carol can run off if she wants to. When she gets back, we still brothers. So she can't go nowhere. Because we ain't going nowhere. When you ain't there, it ain't gonna hide it with Jesus. When you're in, yeah. Like when you're out, God is sending somebody to share word with you because you're truly in trouble. But when you're in, you're in. We weren't in-laws, we were brothers. I want you to know out there. We're sisters, we're brothers, we have a mother, we're mothers, but we have a father. We have a heavenly father. So we're united in love because God loved us like that. No steps, just blessed, just elected. She loved her nieces. Her nephews with all her heart. She loved all her friends. She enjoyed cooking. A hand or two of cards. And you know she was from Arkansas, so she liked to live down on blues. And a cold beer every now and then. Not every night, every day. You just gonna be real. And then Brother Mike liked a little R&B. I don't do the bill no more, but I'm not judging. Because occasionally we'd be together at family functions and she would pull me aside and we'd talk about the Lord and we'd share a little bit with her and she'd still be drinking her beer. So to the earth eye, the carnal eye, you'd think she wouldn't listen. It don't always stick right then. But you do what God called you to do. You fellowship with your family. You spend time with them. You are elected and you are a representative. So we hang in there with the family. Even try to play on the dominoes. I'm no good, but I try. You know, I can't count well. Only so many fingers and so many toes. I got to look down at them sometimes. So they just let me watch most of the time. They don't really let me play. But she had a life well lived on this side. 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 3 tells us. But the end of all things is at the hand. So therefore be serious and watchful in your prayer. And above all things, have fervent love for one another. For love will cover a multitude of sin. That ain't Mike's word. That's God's word. Love will cover a multitude of sin. It ain't based on the law. Based on faith in Jesus. Proverbs 10 tells us. Verse 12. Hatred stirs up conflict. But love covers all offenses. Is that right, Dick?
Amen.
My sister Flo, I want you to know she wasn't no hater. And she had love in her heart. I tell you, but she would get you right. She'd set you free. Thought about, you know, James Brown had that song, Papa Don't Take No Mess. My sister Flo didn't take no mess. She didn't know karate, but crazy. She didn't know karate, but she knew crazy. Amen. She get you right now. Amen. But she had love in her heart. We're going to get there. Getting close. Death is a passageway. That's what I want the family to know. It's just part of the journey. Death on this side. By testimony from family, it had been said that Flo, in the last few days, that last week, we got the call last week, and they were a very private couple, very proud. Family just didn't know how bad it was. You know, they tried to fight it on their own. You know, so when Carol and the rest of the family got the call, you know, one doctor said it might be 6 months, and one doctor said 3 weeks, and she didn't make it but 5 more days. But there was still time. Flo said to witnesses in the room, Jesus is here. Jesus is here. She said, I'm afraid because I see Jesus. She said, I love him. Told her daughters, Mickey, I love you. Told her husband, I love you. She asked her daughter, when are my sisters coming? Because I saw Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Psalms 34, verse 4 tells us, I sought the Lord, and he heard me, and delivered me from all my fears. See, that's word. She still had time. They looked upon him and were enlightened, and their faces were not ashamed. She saw Jesus. In my spiritual mind, I can hear from saying, I have just a few more things, Lord. I won't before I come home to rest. But I see Jesus. Jesus, you my rock. Jesus, you my way. Jesus, you my God. Jesus. The word tells us to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. She saw Jesus. Oh, Lord, thank you. That time we spent together, that word that was being shared, that love that was being shown, we think they ain't listening. But she saw Jesus. Oh, we were so happy because we were truly celebrating. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 9 tells us, eyes have not seen, nor ears heard, neither entered into the hearts of man the thing which God has prepared for them that love him. But God have revealed them to us by the Spirit. She saw Jesus. Can't no scientist explain that. Wasn't no confusion where she wanted to go. Wasn't no confusion that she was elected. Wasn't no confusion about the law and all the accomplishments. But it was about Jesus. Her face was lightning, and her daughter and her one of the other family members of a different denomination, a different faith, and we're not putting down, said, she saw something because I could see it in her eyes. Yeah. Jesus. Yeah. Witnesses along the way. Yeah. Gave her time. She had her house right and in order. And we ain't talking about the house they was living in on earth. Yeah. We talking about she had her spirit right. Yeah. She was not separated from God. She had accepted Jesus as Lord and Savior. It was about Jesus. Oh, what a testimony.
Yeah.
So we stood there in the Rocky Mountains. It's not about Reverend Mike. Don't get caught up in me. Get caught up in the Word. Get caught up in Jesus. Because Flo received the Word. She received Jesus as Lord and Savior. And she was resting with Jesus. One day, we're going to all have to go that way. I want you to know that. Is your house in order? Or are you looking to earthly things? It's not in a can of beer. It's not in cigarettes. It's not in life. It's not in pleasing the flesh. It's not in the problems of this world. But Jesus is the answer. And she saw Jesus. And the Lord allowed her to be a testimony to her husband and her child and her family. Where do you stand? If you caught out there on earthly things, depending on the law, depending on money, depending on your job, you're going to fail. Because all that's going to be wiped away. The only thing that's going to stand is the body of Christ, because he's coming back. And he's going to be looking for those who have trusted and believed in him. It's about Jesus. He was born. He lived. He preached. He taught. He healed. Paid the ultimate cost on Calvary. Nails in his hands. Nails in his feet.
Yes.
Pierced him in the side.
Yes.
He paid it all.
Yes.
Blood and water ran out.
Yes.
Blood for the remissions of sin.
Yes, sir.
Water for baptism. Ain't no confusion in that.
Yes, sir.
Jesus. My rock, my way.
Yes.
What do you stand?
Yes.
Jesus.
Yes.
We can preach that anyway.
Yes.
Rocky Mountains. Don't need an amen. I'm caught up in Jesus. Never said a mumbling word. But we know he laid there 3 days. Had given it up for you and I. He died for you, for I, for the ones that are lost, to the ones yet to be saved. It's predestined. You have been given time. How do we know? Because of one Sunday morning, he got up, the power to make you walk right, power to make you talk right, power to make you live right.
Struggling for their lives. the stressed, the depressed. But with the power invested in me, I came to speak life over you. I speak blessings of health, blessings of peace. To my brothers and sisters all around the world, especially those in South Africa, struggling with AIDS, in Brazil, the States. I speak life, you're gonna live. Oh, my brother, my sister, I speak life, you are the head and not the tail. You will prevail. I speak life, don't give up. Shall live and not die. Let's not lose another person to a senseless death. Substance abuse, gang violence, suicide because of low self-esteem. The power of life and death is in the tongue. Speak life over yourself and those you love.
Help me sing that.
I speak life, you're gonna live.
Say it again.
I speak life, you are the head and not the tail. You will prevail.
Say,
I speak life,
don't give up the fight
for your life. You shall live.
Thank you for listening to Praise On every Sunday morning, sharing God's word, praise, worship, and honor to meet you at your need and where you stand. Praise On. Our Bible verse comes from Psalm 146, verse 1. Let all that I am praise the Lord.
What we're going to do right here is go back, way back, back into time.
Yeah, he's waiting. Oh, Jesus, can I believe it? Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, Jesus, yeah. Let me tell you.
Dixie hummingbird.
Well, the road
sing every now and then. Most of the time when people give a concert, we'd always run into Slim. You know, Slim could be the difference in a meal or maybe none. Slim is when you look for 300 people, you don't see but 21. But we've been singing on the mountain ever since we were 19. Riding the highways and all of our pockets. We, who are we?
If you would like to find out about upcoming shows or add any feedback regarding our show, you can hit us up on Facebook. Our page is Praise On Worldwide. And now, let's get back to Praise On. Are listening to Praise On. Check out our Praise On Media Ministry video library on YouTube. You can also get in touch with us on Facebook. Our page is Praise On Worldwide. And now, back to Praise On.
Just can't give up now.
I won't give up now.
redemption was sure to be. But thank God for angels that are shielding and protecting and looking out for me. Thank you, Lord. The devil had a plan to kill me, I know. But God intercepted his plan and told the devil, go.
Hurt you, or the truth can change you. What will truth do to you?
I just wanna be happy, but if I keep on doing the things that keep on bringing me pain, there's no one else I can blame if I'm not happy. Wasted time, but now I can see the biggest enemy, it was me. So I'm not happy. Cry yourself to sleep. Shout and raise your hands. It won't change a thing, child, until you understand.
Preach.
If you're tired of being the same, if you're tired of things not changing, it's time for you to get out the way. Don't get stuck.
But it only works if
you wanna be happy.
Look at yourself and say,
don't you wanna be happy?
I like Love Surprise every Saturday morning because I love it. Praise on.
Hallelujah.
We thank you for listening and we hope that you got your praise on. This show is produced by Reverend Michael Middlebrook and Leonard C. Middlebrooks. This is a production of Praise On Incorporated.
Come on, lift up your hands and say, I won't go. Say,